Welcome everyone to Defender for Cloud in the Field. Once again, thank you very much for the audience. If you are not a subscriber to the Microsoft Security Channel, make sure to subscribe and primarily to this AKA link below, which has our playlist with all Defender for Cloud episodes. With that, today this is a very interesting episode because coincidentally, 1 year ago today, I actually was in ILDC in Israel, and I was talking to Yael, which is our guest today, about recording an episode. And 1 year later, we are making it happen. So, Yael Genut, thank you very much for being on today.
Thanks for having me.
It took only 1 year for us to do this episode, but that's good. At least we are getting done today. Yael, tell us a little bit more about what you do for Microsoft.
Okay, so I'm a product manager at the Cloud Security Posture Management team. In my role, I'm especially focusing on security recommendations. And I'm totally excited to talk today about custom recommendations, a new feature we recently released to public preview as part of the Defender CSPM plan.
Yeah, the Defender CSPM plan is a big hit. We released at Microsoft Secure in GA. And before we go deeply into this new capability, give us an overview. What about custom recommendations and why secure teams needs this capability so much?
Yeah, sure. So I will start with a brief overview of what custom recommendations are. Actually, Microsoft Defender for Cloud has default security standards that include comprehensive sets of security recommendations. However, as every organization also has its unique internal requirements, we understand that security teams need to create their own custom standards and recommendations. This capability is essential for aligning MDC with their business goals and compliance requirements. So with the new feature, customers can now create custom recommendations by building queries in Kusto Querly Language. And as part of the new experience, we developed a user-friendly query editor that enables security teams to query the raw data from the native cloud and assist to build and test the custom recommendation query.
This is a very interesting feature, and as you said, a lot of customers, they ask about this. So I'm going to change a little bit the dynamics of today's episode. We're going to go straight to the demo so that you show how this feature works, and then I will ask questions along the way. So let's alternate here to the demo environment so you can demonstrate that.
So first I will start by creating a custom standard. You can think of standards as a logical grouping for custom recommendations. I will navigate to the environment settings page. And in the environment settings, I need to select the desired connector. I will choose AWS connector. Then click on standards. And here I can see all the security standards. And I can click on create and standard. So now I need to enter the standard name and description. Let's assume for today that I want to create a custom standard to monitor EC2 instances. So I will write here, custom standard to monitor EC2 instances. Here, let's write EC2 instances. And here I can choose the recommendations. If I already created the past custom recommendation, I can assign them to the standard now. And in addition, I could also assign built-in recommendations. And let's assign two built-in recommendations about EC2 and click on create. I will need to wait a few minutes and then I can see the standard I created. I already created that before the demo, so we can move on. And now after creating the standard, I will be able to see that under the standards tab. So now the next step would be to create our recommendations. In order to create custom recommendation, I will click on create and then recommendations. And now after selecting the create recommendation button, I need to insert the recommendation details. So for this demo, let's assume that I want, for example, to create a recommendations to remove stopped EC2 instances after a specific time period. So now I need to fill in the recommendation details. So the name of the recommendation would be stopped EC2 instances should be removed after a specific time period. In that case, this recommendation already exists, but for example, the default standards recommend to remove stopped EC2 after 30 days. I can decide in my organization that I want to remove stopped EC2 after 15 days. And in that case, custom recommendation would be very useful for me. So in the description, I can explain what is that recommendations and why it is important to remediate it. And in the recommendation, a remediation description, I can explain how to do that. That would be very helpful for the user that is going to remediate the recommendation. In addition, it's mandatory to choose the severity level. I will set it as medium. And let's add a description just to see how it's going to look. I will add it here. And here I can assign it to the custom standard that I want to. For example, let's assign it to the custom standard we created together, this one. And now I will click next. Okay. So now in this, this is where I need to add the recommendation logic. As I mentioned before, the recommendation query is based on Kusto Querly Language. And what is very exciting in this feature that we also developed a query editor that make it very easy to create the recommendations and is very user-friendly. So let's see together this capability. It's also important to say that we recommend using it to in order to create a recommendation. It will allow customers to test their recommendation even before the creation and see the status of the resources. So I'll click on that. Okay. So in this query editor, I can use the built-in recommendation template and change them according to my need. For example, I created a standard to monitor EC2. So let's see what I can find here for EC2. You can see here many examples. So if I want to use the specific recommendation, for example, I can create a query to remove stopped EC2 instances. And as I mentioned before, the built-in recommendation suggests to remove this stopped EC2 after 30 days. I can decide that I want to change it to 15 days. And then I created my custom recommendation.
All right. Yeah, this is really good. And what I really like about this experience is the workflow. Very comprehensive. You know, the wizard goes step by step. You have everything in there. Now, what if I want to really create something from scratch, not using one of those templates?
Sure, let's do that together. You can see here the recommendation template. It contains the instructions to help customers to create their recommendation by their own. And let's do that together. You can see that the first row is always the table name, the same as every Kusto Querly Language query. So let's start with creating. I will delete this and let's do that together. I will start with the table name. Then I need to select the environment and the resource type. A cool capability that we added here is the categories tab, meaning if I want to create a recommendation for EC2 instances, I can write here EC2. And then I can click on EC2 instance. And it will automatically add this row to the query. Then the next part is writing the relevant information and logic that I need in order to create my recommendations. In order to build a query, I need to check what is the status of the EC2 instance and if it's stopped or not, I need to check for how long it has been stopped. So let's see how can I do that. I can run the query now. And I can click here in order to see the resource properties. You can see here the record field. The record field contained the data structure as it returned from the AWS API. That means that security teams should use this field to define the condition which will determine if the resource is healthy or unhealthy. If you are not sure what is the meaning of the value, there is also the SDK information here, and you can read more about that in AWS documentation. But for my recommendation now, I need to check the state of the resource. So I will search for the state. And you can see here that the state is running. So now I know where I can find the information that I need. So I can write this new column alone. I can write here extend to create a new column. And you can see here how the row is written. I can use the dot to enter the specific field that I need. And I will take it from here just to see the example. I can see here the recommendation state. Then the next step would be to check for how long it has been stored. So it will be in the same logic as I did to in order to find the state. Now it will check for the time that it has been stopped. I will add it for you now just to save some time. I will add a new column named stop time. And then I can run it and check it, the status for my resources. This is very cool because you can check that even before creating the recommendation. Yeah, I can see.
Yeah, this is really good. One question that I have real quick, you know, this is the customer's real data. This is not the mock-up data or anything, right? So when you are doing this preview, you are seeing real data.
Yeah, sure. This is very cool. Actually, all the information that I see here in this table is the native API calls from the cloud, from AWS, meaning it's all real data and it's all the real state of the resource.
Excellent.
So actually, this query editor is not only helped me to create a recommendation, it also helped me to evaluate my status and my environment. I can see here the status even before. I can see that this, for example, EC2 is running, and I can see here how long it has been stopped.
That's really awesome. Now, question that I have, once I create this recommendation, how long it takes to start populating on the dashboard?
It's supposed to take a few minutes, and then I will be able to see the recommendation alongside all the built-in recommendations.
Okay. And there is a final step to save this custom recommendation so it can show up there?
Yeah, sure. I will show you how to do that. So just to add to that, now we see the recommendation status, but I always need to add an if statement that determine if the recommendation is healthy or unhealthy. In that case, it means that if it's stopped and the stop time is longer than 15 days, it will be unhealthy. So I will just finish the query. I will add this row that I always need to add at the end of the query. I can run the query and check the health status for each resource even before the creation. You can see here if it's healthy or unhealthy, but let's finish the creation process together. So after I created the recommendation, I need to copy the recommendation from the query editor, and then I will paste it here. We'll click on next. Here I can review the recommendations. I can see the name, the description to make sure everything is as I expected. And then I will click on create. So now we have the custom recommendation. I can see all the custom recommendation I have created here in the custom recommendation tab. You can see here the recommendation. And if I want to edit the recommendation or change something, I can do that directly from here. But the cool part is I can see that also in the recommendation page, I need to enter the all recommendation tab. And here I need to filter for custom recommendation. I will choose for recommendation type. Let's see only the custom recommendation for now. And here I can see the recommendation we've created together. This is very cool because I can see that exactly as all the recommendation, I can use the tools that we have for recommendations, like exemption. I can also assign owner and use governance tool. And that's it. This is how I can
That's really, really amazing. Now, on this page, when you were creating the custom recommendation, you were able to put the remediation steps, right? What about the freshness? Is this something that we'll do automatically according to the type of recommendation that you are creating? It's always going to show this freshness interval?
Yeah. So the freshness interval for custom recommendation is 6 hours for AWS and GCP. And this will happen automatically.
Okay, so you don't need to, you don't have control over that. The only thing that you have control is the remediation steps, correct?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. The other question is, will this custom recommendation appear in any place in the main dashboard where you have the secure controls, or will be under, will not interfere on secure score, for example, because I believe that there is no secure score, there is no assignment for this recommendation to be part of a secure control that influenced the secure score, correct?
Yeah, so no, custom recommendations appears only in the all recommendation tab, and they doesn't affect the score.
Oh,
a recommendation
okay.
appears only in the all recommendation tab.
Okay, that makes sense. Very straightforward. Now, what are some of the prerequisites that customer needs to perform and to use this feature?
So this new capability is part of the Fender CSPM plan. So in order to use the option of creating custom recommendations for AWS and GCP, customers need to have the Defender CSPM plan enabled. Currently, this experience is available only for AWS and GCP, but we are planning to add Azure soon.
Okay, that's good news. See, you heard me first.
Very excited.
Azure will come soon. Yeah, this was a great episode, great demo. Thank you very much for taking the time. Any final consideration, any final recommendation that you want to share before we wrap up?
So while we mentioned that we're still working on this feature, it's currently in public preview, and we have so many cool ideas to add. This is just the beginning. We also want to add in the future the ability to create custom recommendations on the Security Explorer data. Meaning it will be possible to create recommendation on insights, notes, etc. So we'll keep you updated.
Awesome. Only good news. That's amazing. Mm-hmm. All right, everyone. Thank you very much for your time. Yael, thank you again for joining today. I truly appreciate. And stay tuned, because now in April, there is RSA. And there's a lot of announcements coming up, so stay tuned for more episodes. We have a lot more to talk about in the upcoming months. See you next time.